Yeah, so my name is Marc, like Mike said, and we with Ondra are part of WindUp team, which is developing migration tool. Right, it was just one tool, but right now it's more an extended toolkit. So I will show you what the migration toolkit is. I'm in Red Hat 9 years, but before I joined the WindUp team, I was developer and then project lead of the SIM framework. If you know it, it's right now in heaven, so discontinued and not maintained. But what is WindUp? WindUp was originally some string tool which was helping solution architects to migrate the applications, and it was based on Spring framework, but it was really easy to search some string patterns and suggest or provide some migration recommendation or suggestion. It was redesigned in previous 2 years, so right now it's like a rule-based engine. So if you know JBPM or BRMS, it's on the same idea. And the rule is basically processing some conditions or one condition, and based on if it's a match, the condition, some operation is happening. Right now, mostly the tool is creating reports and suggestions. It's not a fully automated tool, but you know, the coding and migration of code is not sometimes straightforward, so it needs and requires some higher intelligence like AI. So that's it. And if somebody wants to know, it's based on JBoss Forge, which is a pluggable engine for rapid application development and for scaffolding. So in the core is Forge, and it's working architecturally like engine, the core, and created develop add-ons. So if somebody wants to use AirShops or some application which was developed in past, you know that it's really quickly outdated, and the cost of maintaining this application is really more and more expensive. So the help with the migration to new technologies is more than welcome. There were many tries how to achieve this. So there are plenty of migration assistants, but only this WindUp is really open source and available for all users for free. What is really not free or in time and in cost is creating and developing the rules which are migrated or which are creating the migration process. So we have developed some assistant which could help you, but it's not everything. You still need to have some knowledge about the source technology and the target technology, because without that you can accept only the suggestion without any things. By the way, Ondrej Žižka is here, so I think he will be introduced later by himself. Yeah. So everything from the outdated technology to the new technology needs some help And what is important is trying to understand what is the differences between this target and source technology. Or it could be just a library, because if you try, for example, migrate or run application from EAP5 or JBoss AS5 on the current platform like JBoss Wildfly or Red Hat EAP7, it will be probably not running out of the box if you just take the application on the new platform. So you can see some exceptions probably, and we'll try to find out how to sort it out, these issues. So yeah, here is the example of the some application which probably use Java EE, even it's not on the current Java EE 7 platform. So you need to do something. You know that, for example, EJBs were really simplified from the EJB2. So, and if you know that you have multiple components which are using this technology, it's not really easy to get and resolve all issues just from the top of your head. So you need some help. And if you know there are multiple relations and dependencies which every component can use, so it's very hard. So we are trying to bring some help with Windup, and this is the example of how to looks the processed analysis by Windup. It's a HTML report which could be helpful for some high-level overview what's in your application, because sometimes it's not only that you know the application you are trying to migrate, but for almost all time you need to migrate application you don't you didn't develop, and you are not sometimes even able to get the sources, so it's really hard. So Windup is trying to you to get the analysis, something like that. These yellow boxes are some hints how to migrate, for example, used code in looking for initial context, and that's it. So, demo. Actually, I would try to say that B used to be just command line tool. So you have some applications on your local disk, and you will run the command line tool, and that's it. The report will were generated, and you will see what's in. But it's more that you need to run the analysis and the migration in bigger teams. So we are in the current development trying to achieve this in a Windup web service, which is application, which are still running on the core of Windup, but it's available like any other web service or web application. So you can run it in cloud, you can run it on your team server and collaborate with other teammates on the analysis. So you can view it and just try the migration steps. So I will show you just in a few seconds how it's run. It's obviously using Docker because it's on hype right now. And you will see everything correct. And I already started, so I know that there is some Docker container, but it's now right now installed. So I will run it and I can see what's happening. So it's starting under cover the WordFly with the AU1.web web application. After the start, I can use the application. So we are using SSO through the keycloak, so you can publish the instance if you want and just create some users. So right now it could be multi-projects migration, so every company has probably more teams which are doing the migrations, because some companies have 1,000 applications and they probably can try to migrate half or thirds. So it's it could be divided into migration projects. And here, for example, is we are using some attributes for the application project, because not every project are the same. And we are using rules for some libraries or frameworks and so on. So we are trying to categorize and group the rules which are used in migration into some migration paths. So we have some core rules, for example, for descriptors, for Java code, which are in source technology written on WebLogic server. And if we are trying to migrate, for example, to EAP 6 or 7, we have some target recommendation for such types of migration. So if I use this migration path, and I know that most companies are using some high-level domain identification of packages, I can reduce the analysis, and this is probably all what I have for the configuration of the analysis. If you, I see here the report, you can see that it is very similar to what I had in the presentation. Because it's already processed analysis. And if I go here, we have, this is the static reports, and we are through the this wind-up web application trying to be close to the users, so we can generate some dynamic reports, which could be probably more interested in developers which are doing the migrations. So they can show what's in the reports and so on. So for example here, this WebLogic descriptor, there are some classification that this file is probably not fully compliant to XML validations, and some suggestion. Even you can have some template for generated JBoss EJB descriptor from the existing web logic descriptor. But what it's interested, you can have here some summary reports, dependencies, so you can directly see what the application is using, and probably if it's a Maven artifact, you can see the Maven coordinates. So this is more like the preparation for the migration, but if you are really at the time that you have some task, like you need to migrate existing code, so you can try and use your IDE. For our development, we are based on Eclipse, so we have some plugins which can help the real migration in the development or in the code. So here I will show you the Eclipse IDE, where we have installed wind up plugin. It's available on JBoss tools JBoss org update site location here. So everybody who can know how to install plugins in Eclipse, they can get just this URL and install the plugin with this option, like install new software, here is URL, and so on. So I won't spend time on this because it's time and traffic worth. So I can show you the example of how to work in Eclipse, because it's would be beneficial for the imagination how it's used. So if we are using Eclipse, we have wind up a special perspective, which is who didn't use the Eclipse, it's it's a layout how to have some views, and it's sorted, so you can have very the same layout. You can have different perspectives, like standard Java EE, but this helps user to use effectively the IDE. So we have here the windup perspective, and if you run the windup here, it's called like windup server because it's not running as a standalone process. It started and it's waiting in memory for the processing or for the launching. So I already processed the example project, so you can see that there are some categorization of issues, which is basically propagated in reports too. So I can show you that here is very the same what I show you in Windup web, and this is the static report. So I can follow links here in Windup perspective in IDE too, but it's not everything. I can show you that some issues which are mandatory in migration. Can be viewed here too, like in issue detail. You don't need to go through the report, because here if I would have the bigger screen, you will see it on one view, but here it's smaller, so I maximize this little view. And here you can see that this is the WebLogic Transaction Manager usage. Here is some recommendation what to do. So replace with the standard Java East class Transaction Manager. Here is, of course, some link to it. And if you need some more details, we have some knowledge base on Red Hat documentation portal, and you can follow more details in that link. So that's it. If it's enough for you, you can directly edit the code, and you are resolving the issue probably in a few seconds. But right now this is not the case, so I will show you more probably easy hanging fruit to migrate. So here you can see at least part of the title, that there is a WebLogic proprietary logger used. So I see that it's in probably two files. And this is sometimes very easy to migrate. For example, this, I will use some log4j, or you can use Java unified logging. It's on you. So it's on you what you are needing. Just fix the code. So everything is replaced, and if I see these little warnings or errors, I can try to process the wind up again, and we'll see if these errors will go away. Meanwhile, you can see here that the windup is launched. I can remove that. And right now it's processing the analysis. So in a few seconds it should be done. And the view in the issue explorer should be reduced at least for these three or four warnings to be fixed. So let's see. And you will see that everything is gone. Here it's syntax error, so it's not the issue from windup, but I forgot the delimiter. This is all what I can say, that this type of error here should be now only in our files But the login filter class, it's not mentioned here in the list. So you are done. These types of help you can use in every other issue which is mentioned here or listed here in the view. So yeah, I think you know how the migration toolkit at least very shortly is used or can be used. So if you have some questions, I can try to answer. No?
Will anybody have use for this tool in the short term?
Probably. I would expect that not, because it's more advanced thing that an enterprise world that you are migrating something. But if you are a volunteer or somebody who are doing that for fun, you probably will do the from the very zero. But anyway.
Also, Mark?
So, yeah. I think my presentation is at the end. So, if you seriously don't have any questions, thank you for the attention.